Hello students, welcome you all. So in today's video lecture we are going to look at the question answers, exercise question answer solution on this chapter, the Great Indian Desert, chapter number 5. So look at the question, what is a desert? So we all know that desert is a land which is full of sands only, and it has only little rainfall. So desert is a barren area of landscape where little precipitation occurs, and consequently living conditions are hostile for plant and animal life. It means that the life is difficult in desert, and it is made of sands where only little rainfall occurs. Now the second question, why are days hot and nights cool in the desert? So we know that the sand heats up easily in the daytime and cools down in the night. So because sand cannot hold heat, it needs a constant source of energy to stay warm, which is the sun. So during the night, when the sun is not shining, the sand loses all its heat, making the desert night cold. While in the daytime sunshine heat up the sand and sun rays fall straight on the sand, making the days hot. So during the daytime the sun makes the sand hot, and during the night time the sand cools, lose heats, and that's why the nights are cold. Next question is, what is a sand dune? Why does it keep shifting? So a sand dune is a mound, hill or ridge of sand. These are the large masses of wind blown sand and are most common in the deserted environments. So these are the small hills of the sands. Sand dunes are the small hills of the sand which are found in the deserts. Now why it shifts? So dunes are not a permanent structures. These are not permanent, okay? So this can change its place. The strong winds of the desert keep moving the dunes from one place to another place. So there are strong winds which blow and keep the dunes, means make the dunes shift from one place to another place. We can see the dunes over here in the picture, that the direction of the wind, the crest is up to 15 meters, and the leeward side, sheltered side of the dunes is steep slip slope, and the windward side is the gentle slope. Okay. Then what is an oasis? Fourth question, what is an oasis? An oasis is a small fertile or green area in a desert region, usually having a spring or well. Oasis provides habitats for animals and plants. We can see the small area where we find water, we find greenery, and we find trees. This kind of place is called an oasis. So oasis can provide shelter for the animals, and it is also the place where plants can grow because of the availability of the water. And otherwise, the other place near or around the oasis can be found as the barren land where no plants and the vegetables or the animals habitat has grown, or they are there. Like you see that there are only sands, and in the middle you can find the place which is full of green leaves and trees with water. Next question is, fifth number, what has been the effect of the Indira Gandhi Canal on the Thar Desert? So the canal has transformed the Indira Gandhi Canal transformed the barren deserts into fertile and good fields. Besides providing water for agriculture, the canal will supply drinking water to hundreds of people in far-flung areas. So this supply water to the people living in the desert area, also it gives the water for the agriculture, okay, and This provides water in the barren field. Next question is that 6 number. Why is camel still an important means of transport in the desert? So camel is an animal where we have seen that it is used in the desert areas of Thar desert or the Rajasthan. So it is the answer is it is the only mean of transportation found in the desert which helps human being go from one place to another easily in the desert. It has humps which help it to survive long dry periods without water. Its feet are thick with which help it to move on the hot sand easily. So there are many things which help the camels to survive in this kind of hostile climate, and they are having humps on their back which store the water, and it is store some food for which the camels can walk and survive without water for many days. Describe the traditional clothes of the people of Rajasthan. So traditional attire for Rajasthani women is ghagra choli, also called kanchil and kurti, and orni. And the traditional outfit for the Rajasthani men is dhoti and angarkha or pajama kurta. So these are the traditional clothes of the people of Rajasthan. Then the last question on the 8th question is name a few tourist attractions of Rajasthan. So there are many tourist attractions in Rajasthan, and we can only name a few over here. Although there are lot of tourist attractions, you can name those tourist attractions also if you want. I have named only few of them. So Ambar Palace, Hawa Mahal, then Ranthambore National Park, City Palace, Chittorgarh Fort are the few of the tourist attractions of Rajasthan. You can see Chittorgarh Fort visuals, and this is Chittorgarh Fort, and then the visuals of Hawa Mahal. So this much for today's question answers. Thank you all.